It's the final week of the year, which means one final week and one final game. I'll get more into next year's plan in the year review that I'm going to do later, so make sure to watch that to find out what's going to happen in 2019. This week, though, I get to talk about the game Ashen. Now, like almost all games on this list, I have no idea what I'm getting into when I start. Is it going to be a good game, or is it going to be a flop? And boy, does this game fit into one of those categories. Ashen is a beautiful game with a beautiful setting and beautiful combat. The combat itself reminds me of Dark Souls, which is not the first time that I've seen that statement made about this game. The reason is that the combat is all about stamina management. You use stamina in attacking, dodging, running, and really everything, so it's all about how to be smart in a fight. And, you know, that means then that I died a lot. I just don't know how to best use stamina. I mean, it's the same reason I did awful when we did that Dark Souls video. I have no idea how to go and manage it. I don't know what the best things to go and do for. I don't know the strategies. I just don't understand it, but that doesn't mean that this game is bad by any long shot. It just means that, you know, I suck at the game. Like, way more than I should have. And as a player, for being someone to go and play it, you get to design how you look in the beginning, have it set up, so it kind of really draws you in there. And the story is painted from the beginning, like by throwing a lot of stuff at you. And then as most stories do in that sense, you get thrown right into it. It's like, okay, here's a book full of information, we're going to throw it at you, and you're in and go. And it's a cool aspect. It does slow with the throw, though, so this way you don't go and show this game as a no-go, you know? I mean, It's a fantastic game. It's really, the story's really thought out, and it's, I want to say, evenly spaced. You have your main quest stuff, you have your side quest stuff, and I'm not going to get into any of it because I never do. But I think the story for it, there's enough to do that it's not really like you're stuck at any point. It's progressing at a normal point where you're unlocking different parts of side quests at the same time that you're doing main quest things, so it's all continuing along the same pattern. And to go with that, the art for the game is absolutely stunning. I always liked games that drew you in, that made you feel, you know, part of the universe, and this game does a great job of doing that. It's something to always, I guess, for lack of a better term, like, appearing in an area, and, like, you walk through this, like, hole in a wall out of a cave, and all of a sudden you just see, like, a plane before you, and then you see the scenery in the background, and you see this giant creature flying overhead, and it's just so breathtaking for that, and I'm just at a loss of words for it all. I mean, this game is fantastic. I love everything about it, and I think that a lot of people will too. I think it's a great game that people who like Dark Souls, people who just like games in general, will go and enjoy. I mean, the characters in it have no facial features at all. They're just kind of like wooden doll, like blank slates there. But they do a good job of showing emotions through the way they talk and the way that they speak, and it's really amazing, and I think that alone is a reason to play this game. With all that said, that's all that I have for this week. No hint, because this was the final week of the year, so have a good year, everyone, and see you in the next one.